I'm so honored to have our city council member, Kathy Narum, to be here to deliver her speech and give our vision of our city. If you have any question, prepare now and ask her later. Thank you, Kathy, to be here. I'm good. Thank you.
Well, I was only expecting to talk a couple minutes, so I maybe have time for more questions. Good afternoon. You know, special thanks to Sylvia for inviting me to celebrate with you. Oh my gosh, that's me, huh? That's actually an old picture. To celebrate with you on your grand opening event of the Tri-Valley Asian Association. You know, it's no question that Pleasanton is really becoming a community of diversity, with a significant percentage of our residents being born in another country. For me, it's been very exciting to watch, in particular, the Asian community begin to become more and more involved and active in our community. You know, certainly Sylvia, who serves on our Economic Vitality Committee and is an alternate to our Downtown Specific Plan Task Force, that's a mouthful, is a great example of that. And we certainly appreciate her input and her perspective, which is, you know, it can be different, and that's okay. In fact, that's wonderful. You know, public service, civic service, it really comes in a variety of different ways. As an example, the mayor, who I think is coming in a bit, he and I both began our public service, interesting enough, as president of the Pleasanton Seahawk Swim Team Board of Directors. And you know, who knew, if I think back, who knew back then that I would be standing here as your elected representative? Now, of course, between being president of the board and standing before you now, I've done a variety of different things, which I think really helped to prepare me. But my point is, you know, you don't know where your service and your volunteerism is going to lead you. So I would really encourage you to learn about all the various aspects and wonderful programs in our city. And I think a really good way to do that is through a program that's called Leadership Pleasanton. It's run through our Chamber of Commerce. I printed this out and I'm happy to leave it. I actually did not do this, and when I was elected, I said to the city manager, do you think I need to do this? And he laughed and said, no, I think you need to be teaching it. But and actually, that would not have been good at that time. This is, I think, a really great way. It meets once a month. It's an all day once a month. I believe registration for it will again be in the fall, the summer fall. And you see everything from, you go out to our fire training center, I think you can climb a ladder on a fire truck if you're so inclined. You see all the wonderful aspects of the city government. They get involved, they show you the school district, and they talk about different volunteer kinds of aspects. And, you know, so to really give you that exposure. So I think most of the members of the city council, and I suspect also the school board, we believe that one of our big responsibilities is to really train and to nurture people to follow us. We have term limits. I can only serve in my position for 8 years, and then I'm done. Doesn't matter how great a job I did. The law says I'm out, and actually I think that's a good thing. So we need to train people and have good leaders, good people ready to step in. So I really encourage you, follow your passion in deciding how you want to participate in this great community. You know, I think the mayor and I have been really good examples about starting in something and going through different paths on the Park and Rec Commission. And I think he's on the Community of Character Collaborative, and just there's just so many different things. But you know, I think this is really the first start. You know, you've obviously shown an interest in wanting to participate and get involved in the community by inviting me here. I see two school board members here, and I think that's really great. And that's where to start, is to learn and then decide what you want to do. And I did bring some business cards. I'm happy to meet with you individually later. I do have to go to another event and talk about specifics or answer questions or, you know, give you some ideas, whatever it is you want. So again, thank you for inviting me. And if you have questions, I'll try to answer them.
Anyone?
And if you want a question about the city, I did hear a question about the active shooter. I can tell you that the police Department, our Pleasanton Police Department, the school district, have a very close collaboration. And the city funds a police officer, I believe, in each, in both high schools, Amador and Foothill. And I think they also do some time in the, they also spend time in the middle schools as well. So safety is absolutely a concern. And I will tell you that for me personally, I believe that the number one role of our local government is safety, police and fire. Because, you know, it's like everybody knows I like parks and trails and things. But you know what? If we don't feel safe to be in those parks and to be in those trails, we're not going to use them, and they're not worth anything. So.
Who won't get the shows? Please speak up.
I have a question, sure. A basic question. So
basic,
I know
that the
city council, there are five council members in the city council. So are the roles different, or are they kind of joined?
That's a great question. So there's a mayor who's elected every 2 years for a total of a maximum of 4 terms. And then the city council members are elected to 2 4-year terms. And at the end of the day, when we're, you see us sitting up there, everybody's vote's equal. So, and it takes 3 votes in our government to do anything. It doesn't matter if there's only 3 people sitting there for a meeting, you still have to have 3 votes to do anything. What we do, and what people don't realize about the role, is being on the city council or being mayor is much more than just those 2 meetings. There are probably, I'm going to say, 50 boards, commissions, committees, and things that we have to provide representation to. So for example, I just literally finished being the president of the, you're gonna laugh, the Alameda County Mosquito Abatement District, which we pay taxes to. If you're a homeowner,
yes,
you're paying some taxes to. And so each city has to have a representative on it, because it's, if we say taxation, what is it, taxation to help me, you're a taxation by representation. So I am in there on behalf of Pleasanton residents who are paying taxes into this, into what we call a special district, to make sure it's, we're getting what we need. So we just, we serve on all kinds of things. One of the things I'm on, which I really enjoy, is there's a liaison committee between the city and the school district, and there's 2 city council members on it. And it happens that the 2 school board members here are both on it from the school district side. And we sit down once a month, hour and a half, talk about it, think up things, you know, and a lot in what the city can do to help the school district, because we have a lot more, I think, flexibility maybe. And the city's only as good as the schools at the end of the day. That's another really important component.
So
answer
another,
your question?
I saw
yes,
another
yes.
Hand, right? Yeah.
Hi. I have lived in Taiwan for 5 years. I really love this city. In the first 4 years, my life was very peaceful. I appreciate the great work by the city council. But in this year, I heard a lot of criminals, like breaking the car windows.
Okay.
Even for myself, I had the front door theft. So my question is about the safety in Pleasanton. Does the council have the program to manage this kind of criminal increase?
Yes, yes. So we don't, you know, so city council members, it's important to understand we set the policy, the goals, and the direction of the city. And if we've done a good job, they're very clear, and then we take that and we bundle it up in the form of a work plan, and we hand it to the city manager, and we say, do it. So the answer, and then the city manager is part of that. He will take, and it's actually a 10-page document that we're now working under. We do it every 2 years. We'll be doing it again spring of next year. But we take that, and we hand it to him. He makes the budget based on that, that then we approve. So in this year's budget, we added 2 additional police officers. That was already done. That was effective July 1 of last year. So we've asked them, you know, they have authorization to go out and hire 2 officers. Now, you know, it's no secret, being a police officer isn't maybe right now the best or best viewed occupation. And so, you know, we do have some openings. We've been having trouble finding candidates that are qualified, but The good news is they just put three or four officers, candidates into the police academy, because they have to go through a, I think it's an 8-week very intense training where they learn the laws and maneuvers, and they meet the physical training before we actually hire. So here's what we've done. We've hired a couple officers. On the positive side of making sure that the officers are doing what we want them to be doing in terms of how they treat people, they're all now required to wear body cams and have body cameras and have them on. You'll see them usually there. You know, hopefully you haven't been stopped by a police officer, but if you have, you'll notice in the pocket there's a body camera right here, little thing. And then we are also equipping them with latest technology. And I know I understand that in the next couple of months or so, we're going to be, the chief is going to be coming forward with some requests for funding for some technology things that will help them. Yeah, things like that. I don't know, you know, exactly, because that's their job to, I'm not the police, you know, the police officer, the public safety business. My job is to say, you know, we want it safe. The other thing that you should know, that I think it's important to know, that you may not be aware of, we have metrics that we measure our staff by. So for example, to your question with the public safety, we want a 30% clearance rate on crime. So we want them to solve 30% or more of the crime. We have response times for emergencies that I believe are 3 or 4 minutes. We want them, if you call in and you know, there's somebody with a gun or about, you know, banging on my door or whatever, we want them to have an officer there within 3 or 4 minutes. The other thing that we've done, that we will be doing, and you're going to be hearing about it, over by the mall, you know, you've probably noticed where the big cranes are, and you've seen the construction. Well, in there, there's going to be a police substation, and it's going to be shared with the BART police and our Pleasanton police. And so I happen to live over by there, and so for an officer who needs to go to the bathroom, write a report, make a copy, they have to come all the way back to City Hall. Now they'll be able to do what they need to do there at the mall. Plus, that's an area of high crime, relatively speaking, in the city, and so we will have likely more of a police presence. So the answer is we're absolutely concerned, and there are some things that are happening. And if I don't know what your neighborhood you're in, if you're in the Vintage Hills neighborhood, I saw some emails yesterday where the chief and some of his crime prevention staff are going to be having a neighborhood meeting. If you're not in that neighborhood and you're interested in it, I would suggest you can email, what is it, City Council and Mayor at cityofpleasantonca.gov, and we'll get something set up in your neighborhood. That's kind of long-winded answer, sorry.
Thank you for the question. One more. Can we hold it short? We really need.
Okay. It's more of an inquiry. So I work in the valley.
You work in what?
In the valley.
Uh-huh.
So the communal space is pretty horrible. I think most of the Alameda County, they live around 880. So if you want to start something about 680, can you get started?
There's a number of things. The mayor just came, and he can probably talk a little bit more about that. But Highway 84, so Pleasanton at the crossroads. The good news is Pleasanton's at the crossroads of 580, 680, right? The bad news is Pleasanton's at the crossroads of 580, 680, because we get cut through traffic for people that want to head out east on 580 to Livermore, Tracy, and beyond. So one of the absolute top priorities of this current city council for traffic is to get Highway 84, the widening of Highway 84, finished so that people will get off at 680 and head on Highway 84 over to Livermore and bypass us. We want to get them off, you know, First Street, etc. But I also think that will help some alleviate just getting people off. You're also going to be seeing these HOV, the high occupancy vehicle lane, under construction on the, I guess it would be on the northbound side of 680. So that should alleviate it. And the other thing that we're doing to try to deal with some of this is get BART extended out to the East Train Station in Livermore. That's a little more long term, but we are working on it. And I won't give you all the issues because it's not something that BART board is supporting. And so Scott Hagerty, in particular Supervisor Hagerty, and others have gotten legislature. So we formed a joint powers authority to work on it ourselves to get BART out. So we're trying to get some things done. It's not going to be the end all. And I think companies are realizing it, probably setting up satellite offices in Pleasanton. I mean, I'm aware of several companies that have offices here and don't require their employees to go 5 days a week down to Silicon Valley to help with some of that.
Thanks.
Mm-hmm.